Hi there, my name's Will Valida, and in this video, we're going to take a look at the state management building block in Dapr. In distributed architectures, we'll usually have a number of independent stateless services that serve a purpose, and these are usually set around a domain, such as ordering items from a shopping store, storing items in a catalog, handling authentication, lots of different scenarios. Now, while services should strive to be stateless, there will be some services that need to track state in order to fulfill a business purpose or operation. Dapr has a state management building block that simplifies state tracking and enables you to store state across a variety of different data stores. Your application can use Dapr State Management API to save, read, and query key value pairs in supported state stores, such as Cosmos DB or Redis. Using a state store component, you can build stateful long-running applications that save and retrieve their state, much like a shopping cart application. With the State Management API building block, your application can leverage features that are typically complicated and error-prone to build, such as setting the choices on concurrency control and data consistency, performing bulk update operations, including multiple transactional operations, and querying and filtering key value data. Dapr state stores are modeled as components, which can be swapped in and out without any changes to your underlying application code. With Dapr, we can include additional metadata in the state operation request that describes how you expect requests to be handled, and this can include concurrency and consistency requirements. Dapr supports optimistic concurrency control using e-tags, and Dapr also supports both strong consistency and eventual consistency, with eventual consistency being the default behavior. Dapr also supports two types of multi-read and multi-write operations, bulk or transactional. With bulk operations, you can group multiple read requests into a bulk or batch operation, and in the bulk operation, Dapr will submit the read requests as individual requests to the underlying data stores and then returns that as a single result. With transactional operations, you can group write, update, delete operations into a single request, which are handled as an atomic transaction. The request will then succeed or fail as a set of transactional set of operations. So now that we understand how this Dapr State Management API works, let's see it in action with an example. Okay, so here I am in Visual Studio Code. To demonstrate this, I've got a very basic C# console application that's going to take a book that I've defined here using this class. It's going to be an order of a book. And we're going to save that, get the book from the state store, and also then delete it from the state store as well. So here I've got a constant string variable called state store. And this is going to be the name of my state store component that I'm going to use to hold and retrieve my application state. I then instantiate a new client for my Dapr client, create my order, and then save the book into the state store using the save state async. In that method, I provide the Dapr state store, the ID of the order object, as well as the order. So the key value is going to be this order ID, and the value is going to be my order. I'm going to write to the console saying that I'm saving this book and printing out the ID. Then I'm going to get the book from the state store. So again, using the get state async method, I'm going to pass in my state store, the name of my state store component, and look for the key or the ID, the order ID as my key. And I'm going to save that to this result variable. And if I can get that, retrieve that book from the state store, I'm going to print out getting book with the order ID of that book. And then finally, I'm going to delete the book from the state store. I'm going to do that using the delete state async method. And I'm going to pass in the name of my state store component. And I'm going to use the order ID as my key to delete that book from my state store. So let me open up a terminal and let's run the following command. I'm going to use Dapr run again. I'm giving my app the app ID of book catalog, and I've got a resources path that points to a components folder. So let me go back into Visual Studio and actually show that. So the state store component has been defined as a YAML file. For my state store, I'm going to be using the Redis container that gets provisioned for us when we initialize Dapr. And I'm just going to provide some metadata to connect to the Redis host and also the password. There are lots of different types of state stores that we can use. My favorite one is Cosmos DB, but you can also use Redis that's hosted in the cloud somewhere. You can use MongoDB, Cassandra, SQL, all different types of data stores. Different data stores will use different metadata. You need to be sure how to configure state store components to see how the different data stores that are supported in Dapr work. And I'll put a link in the description that shows you how to implement different state stores. Another important point to state is that the metadata values can contain secrets, which are viewed in plain text. So there's no plain text value here for the password because I'm just using the local container. But it's recommended that for production workloads that you use a secret store, and I'll cover that in our next video. So please don't store secrets in plain text for your applications. I'm going to go back into my terminal and let's run this command. That's going to start up my Dapr application. And there we go. So look at these three lines. I've saved my book, I've retrieved my book, and now I've deleted it. Let me go back into Visual Studio Code, go back into my program.cs file, and let me just comment these two lines out. What I want to do now is rerun it so we actually save the book into the state store, we can retrieve it, but then not actually delete it. And then let's actually query the state store directly to see what the item looks like. I'll go back into my terminal, clear up a little space, and run the command again. So there we go. My book has been saved, and we've also retrieved the book as well. So to see what this looks like in my Redis container, I've got another terminal open, and I'm going to hit this docker exec command and use the Redis CLI to query my Redis container. So if I wanted to list all the keys by my app ID, I just type in keys and then book catalog, which is the name of my Dapr application, star. And there it is. So it's saved in the format of application name and the key name as well. Now, if I wanted to get the state data, I can run hget book catalog one data. And there we go. So I've got my order ID, the title, War and Peace, the author, Leo Tolstoy, and the price. So there's my specific state data. So without having to write any Redis specific code, go back into Visual Studio Code, I've used the Dapr SDK to save the book into state store, and then I can retrieve the book from the state store either by the Dapr SDK, HTTP, or by querying Redis directly. And if I wanted to delete the book from the state store again, I could just uncomment these two lines. And remember, this state store component is pluggable. So if I decided to change my backend store from Redis to SQL Server or Azure Cosmos DB, all I'd need to do is change the YAML file that defines my state store. I wouldn't need to make any changes to my application code. Let's wrap this up. So that wraps up this video. In this video, we learned how the state management building block works in Dapr, and how we can use it to store state using the Dapr SDK. In the next video, we'll take a look at the secrets building block and how we can use it to deal with secret information, such as passwords and connection strings within our Dapr applications. If you like this video, give it a like. If you have any questions on Dapr, please ask them in the comments below. And if you want to see more videos on Dapr, don't forget to subscribe. No matter where you are in the world, I hope you're having a great day, and we'll see you all next time. Thank you.
We'll be right back.